If you know anything about this guy, let me know. Because we gotta get the word out on this terrorist. Whoever he is, we're gonna make him pay.
What a prick. Hey everyone, it's Ryan. We're gonna do a Let's Play on Infamous, like we always talked about. Now, here's the thing. Last Let's Play, End of Resistance, everyone was like, or a few people were like, hey, let's play Dead Space. So I actually started recording it. I did part one, I finished it, and then, like, I lost, like, the footage. Like, my fucking capture software didn't save the whole thing, and I was like, oh, that's bogus. And I wasn't gonna, like, I didn't want to, like, record another one, so I was like, okay, let's do Infamous, which people said we could do that as well. So let's just start.
Plus 6 minutes. Pulse is 45. Respiration 10. Looking good, Cole.
The hell happened? Oh, God.
Alright, so we're doing some Infamous, and oh man, the camera's all messed up. Can I change that? Yes. There we go. I know there's some dialogue that's gonna be coming up, and I don't know if I should talk over it, because, you know, sometimes people want to hear that stuff. I guess I should keep talking to a minimal while the whole story unfolds, because I do love Infamous's story. Oh, Jesus Christ. Let the whole goddamn thing fall on me. Okay, not the way to go. It's been like 2009, actually, since I last played the game. I got my platinum, and then I just moved on. But I did play it twice. So, okay, not the way to go. Where do I go? Okay, maybe over here would make sense.
What's happening to me?
If you're able to walk, please evacuate across the bridge to the Neon. Remain calm. Emergency personnel are en route.
Cole's got some good limping action going on over here.
Over here, man. We gotta go. while sliding into unconsciousness, I could somehow, I don't know, hear the voices of the dying. Thousands crushed by falling buildings or burned alive in the fires. Trish lost her sister, almost lost me. Zeke was always there, somehow sure that I'd wake up while outside the city fell apart. A plague struck, followed by rioting, theft, rapes, civilization committing suicide. In a bullshit attempt to contain the biological threat, the federal government locked down all access in and out of the city. Now we're stuck in this cage with the psychos. Cops are all but gone off the streets, either dead or too chicken shit to stand against the gangs that control things now. Outside, things were bad. But inside me, something was beginning. Scary as hell at first. Gotta understand, there was no one to talk to, no experts to consult. But with time, I'm learning to control it, master it. Just hope it's not too late.
Yay! Oh man, I love this game. I am legitimately pumped to give it a go again. Only 14 days into the quarantine, and we're really getting used to our electrical stuff.
I thought you were gonna watch TV.
Batteries are dead again. You mind putting on a freak show?
Sure. I'm glad it's good for something.
Probably need to charge them all. TV's a hog.
So we're gonna charge the TV so our fat friend can watch some television. We're here.
Nice job, man. Boob tubes are working.
Weird. It feels like I got more power.
Yeah? But try frying those dummies over there. With all the nutballs running around, it'd be nice to see how much juice you're packing. Yeah! Lay into it, man. Fry those suckers. Yeah! Woo-hoo-hoo!
Always hated mannequins.
Whoa! You see that? Flying so low, thought it was gonna crash into us. Hey, it's a TV jacker. I love this guy.
Just got word that the feds dropped some relief packages into Archer Square. The liars running the corporate media tell us that we're gonna get our fair share, that more is coming. Yeah, that's easy for them to say. They're not the ones living in this hellhole. And the truth is that we've been abandoned, and no one's coming to save us. So head over to Archer Square and get that food before the Reapers show up. Voice of Survival, out.
Told you they dropped food.
Man, you must be out of your mind. Think any of those pencil necks gives a crap about us? This is a PR stunt.
That isn't gonna stop you from pigging out, though, is it?
Hell no, it ain't. Zeke's gotta eat.
You take the stairs. I'm using the express elevator.
Oh, man, you get to have all the fun.
Woo!
That's what I'm talking about.
Whew! Oh, that was one hell of a jump, man. Wish I could do something like that. Running down all those stairs. That sucks donkey balls. Hey, Cole, before we head over to Archer, I need to go pick up a new six-shooter.
Oh, here we go.
Ah, that was badass! The second you touch it, the electricity in your hands cooks off the gunpowder, and the whole thing goes kabam! Look on your face was priceless.
Damn near blew my hand off.
Which is why you won't be touching the new one. Traded this guy one of my homemade batteries for it.
The ones that explode when you use them?
Hell, he doesn't know that. Come on. Told me he was gonna leave the gun in the parking lot a few blocks from here. Hey, Cole. You know what I miss? Pizza. Big, sloppy slice. dripping with grease and pepperoni. And payday, having a big fat wad of bills in your pocket.
Yeah, I'd settle for some hot water.
Hey, remember that time we were coming home from Duffy's and I had to take a leak? And that bike cop was yelling at me to put up my hands.
You pissed all over him.
He told me to put up my hands. While he's fumbling around, I jump back in and we take off. Awesome.
Yeah, awesome. Until we run into a wall of cops.
Like I said, awesome. Bummer we won't be able to do anything like that again.
Yeah, not unless some genius invents a car that doesn't explode when I sit in it.
Come on! He told me he was gonna leave it under a car. I figured there'd be only one. We'll never find it.
Stand back. I got an idea.
Woo-hoo-hoo! Hellacious! Hell, I didn't know you could do something like that.
Yeah, me neither. There was this surge.
Hey, man, you don't look so hot.
Trained all of a sudden. Hang on a sec. That?
Man, you're a walking battery. You must have to recharge whenever you fire off a bunch of juice.
I can feel the electricity surging through me, almost like I'm being healed by it.
Oh, this rock's so hard. Come on, let's haul tail over to Archer Square before someone takes all the brewskis.
Cole, you there?
Hey, babe.
You hear they dropped some food?
Yeah, Zeke and me are heading over there.
How are you feeling?
All right, I guess. Powers are all over the place. It used to be I could barely power a light bulb. Now I'm jumping off of buildings, frying the junk on Zeke's roof.
You jumped off a building? What were you thinking?
Relax. I'm fine.
Just take it easy. After what happened to Amy, I couldn't...
Yeah.
See you guys at Archer Square. I love you.
You too.
You too. Ooh, that's gonna burn. Can't even say I love you back to his babe, man. If you couldn't tell, there's a lot of dialogue in this game, so I may stay silent for a good portion of it, which is probably a good thing. Let's be honest here. I don't need to talk about everything. Or tell meaningless stories like throughout most of the Resistance Let's Play, or all the other Let's Plays I've done. And I think it's fair to say we're gonna play good, because I always like to play good, and that's just my personal preference. Unless you say otherwise that you want to play evil.
Boy, it's stuck up there. I hate to say it, pal, but you're the only guy here who'd live from a fall like that. You gotta climb up there and knock that stuff free.
So now we get to go climbing.
Everyone I know.
So yeah, man, I did a 30-minute Dead Space Let's Play because I noticed a few people. Jake, specifically, Jake Harding, one of my subscribers, who's currently playing the game, he's probably already done with it by now, but he mentioned, hey, play Dead Space. And the thing about me picking a new Let's Play is, like, there's never an overwhelming majority of, like, what game to play, right? There's only, you know, a handful of you guys, so there's never a clear-cut answer, but I was like, okay, how about Dead Space? That'd be fun. And I recorded it. And it was coming out all good and well, and then I only 5 minutes of the actual gameplay saved.
We are eating.
Damn. Too late. That's where I caught my first sight. The Reapers. Before the blast, they were just a bunch of junkies dealing drugs. Now, they own the Neon District. Taking whatever they want. That changes today.
There we go. Now for the fun. Some actual good old-fashioned gameplay. Again, have not played this since 2009, so it's really awesome to go back and give it a go.
Dang, those freaks are brutal.
This game still looks pretty good for what it was. clearly, as games get better, they certainly spoil us. Especially, you know, visually for sure. And we're right off the heels of Infamous Second Son, so... certainly a step backward in that regard. But I really enjoyed pretty much everything about Infamous, from its story to the powers. Really enjoyable open world experience.
Yeah, that's the last of them. It's chow time.
A lot of food here. Enough to feed the three of us for weeks, maybe longer. Bet if I fry a couple people in the crowd, the rest will run away. The food will be all ours, but some of these guys might starve.
And I'm gonna let him eat because I'm a good guy. I just can't bring myself to be evil unless it's for a trophy. And that's why 70% of the people that played this game all chose to play a good playthrough. And thus why Sucker Punch chose to make the good ending for both of these games canon. Yes, I'm aware of the karmic system. Thank you very much.
Hey, Trish.
Oh, I'm so glad you got the food down. These poor people are starving.
Just doing what I can. Someone had to help them.
Those idiots dropped us canned prunes. Now who the hell'd want to eat this crap?
Take a look at this, Sapphire City. The product you're seeing was taken by a security camera near Ground Zero. This is the man that destroyed our city, our lives. Someone from your family died? Well, now you know who to blame. If you know anything about this guy, let me know. Because we gotta get the word out on this terrorist. Whoever he is, we're gonna make him pay.
What a prick.
Ever been called a terrorist? All I remember from that day is going to work and then running for my life. That video, though. How'd I get that package? Why would I deliver a bomb? For who? Regardless, the consequences are everywhere. Whatever there'd been between Trish and me was gone. She didn't say a word. No emotion, nothing, just walked away. By then, people nearby were starting to recognize me. It was gonna get ugly. Even Zeke was giving me weird looks. He and I made quick plans to meet up at Stamton Bridge. Try to get out of town. Just hope he shows. Because right now, I'm a little short on friends.
Your actions have made you more heroic. Oh, thank you. Medium difficulty. See, I want to talk, but I don't know when, I don't know when dialogue is going to get prompted up, and then I gotta stop talking abruptly, you know? I don't want to have it all disjointed and stuff.
We are not gonna die because of you.
So everyone hates me, and they're gonna throw rocks at me, and they're not gonna like me.
Zeke, thanks for watching my back.
Sure, man. I ain't about to do anything that might piss you off. See ya.
So, I'm going to assume that you have played the game, or at least have a little bit of context in it. Cole is more or less just a simple delivery guy, but then he delivers what appeared to be some kind of bomb. It's called Race Fear. Shit blows up. You know, the whole city is, like, destroyed. You know, you just saw the Reapers a little bit. They used to be, like, drug dudes, but now they're, like, you know, using the whole quarantine of the city to their advantage. And Cole, got some powers out of that, little explosion. I really like kind of the, morality struggle that, the whole game presents to you as the player. And then, you know, you saw the whole thing with Trish, Cole's girlfriend. I love everything about it. This is a really awesome game. I really enjoyed it a lot. So hopefully we all enjoy this little ride. Be with me, please. Enjoy it. savor every single moment of it. It's like a good cheeseburger at a restaurant that you don't want to finish, and you start actually getting like you get certain, you feel emotionally depressed. Like, you know what, this burger is gonna be gone eventually, and I really shouldn't eat another one because it's really unhealthy. A lot of bacon.
Stampton Bridge, the fastest way out of town. That is, if you can get us past those baton-wielding goons.
We're getting out of here, one way or another. Follow my lead.
Zeke runs like he has a stick up his ass.
You have entered a restricted area. Lethal force may be used at any time.
Gonna have to get past those riot cops if we want out of here. If I fry a couple of the guards from inside the crowd, but I can trigger a riot. Help keep the heat off Zeke and me. Of course, that means a lot of innocent people will get the hell kicked out of them.
Please, I don't want to die. Attack the police on your own or fire them from the crowd. Nah, B. I represent the people. I want the people to know I'm on their side. I'm for them. Vote for me. Conduit of the year, 2009. Now we can power up this door and open it on up. I gotta tell you, man, when you're part of the YouTube game and you're making YouTube videos, it fucking blows when you record something and you lose the footage somehow. I was feeling good about that Dead Space Let's Play I did, man. I was energetic. I was feeling it. I was saying things. I was telling you stories like I often do. They weren't even that good stories, to be, you know, perfectly honest with you. But some of the standard stuff, like, how are you? How have you been? Because I miss you sincerely. I don't know, what else did I say? I kicked that guy back by accident. I don't even remember what the fuck I even talked about, really. Wow, medium difficulty, really kicking my ass already. Gotta keep in mind, open world game here, so there's gonna be a lot of filler missions and like side missions and stuff. And there's the blast shards you can hunt for that expands the top left bar of how much electricity you can constantly use. And I mean, you know, that's something that's a lot of filler content that's not necessarily something you want to watch as a viewer. So I would keep the flow going with just standard missions. Like, we'll just keep going to every single mission. If I find the need to clear open some of the city districts of the game, or collect a few extra blast shards for me, or do some of the stunts in the game, which doing stunts, I kind of forget what they see right there. Stunt 2 of 21 and Enviro takedown. I forget if that's just for trophies or if that does have a benefit for you. I'm not entirely sure. I don't remember completely. In terms of buying power-ups, I think we should be fine on that, where I don't have to do anything extra. Purely because you do get a lot of extra points for just every single thing that you do. Jesus. I'm getting my ass kicked here. Oh. Shit. The political dude got him. The freedom fighter people. Jesus Christ, where is he? Oh man, I ain't trying to die, alright? Oh, I forgot what I even had it set to now. There we go, easy. And there's like no electricity around here either. Ow. So there's a lot of dialogue, so this may not be your traditional Ryan Benecki Let's Play where I say a lot of things that really have no greater meaning. It's more than likely a good thing.
The gate opened to a wall of razor wire machine guns. Zeke made a break for it, smashed in the gate to the decontamination unit, and fell headlong into the harbor. And I moved faster than I knew I could. I was greeted by name. This FBI agent, Moya, had seen the footage of me at Ground Zero and came here to wait, figuring I'd try to escape, knowing I'd have powers. She explained that before the blast, her husband John had been assigned to infiltrate the First Sons, a shadowy group working on a project they called the Ray Sphere, a device designed to drain the neuroelectric energy from a group of people and concentrate it into an individual. She'd lost contact with John the night of the blast. Despite all her connections, Moya was losing hope. Yet she'd found me, somehow believing I could be trusted, ready to make me an offer. I go back to the city, find John in the Ray Sphere, and she'll get me out of the quarantine and clear my name. This whole Ray Sphere thing sounds crazy to me. Suddenly I'm a human light socket, so maybe I should cut her some slack.
Because of the riot topside, this is the only way back into the city. Given the state of our new partnership, I've taken the liberty of cloning your phone's frequency. I've got a lock on your GPS locator, and I can hear every word you say.
That's super.
Now, clearly, we're doing all this, running and jumping because, you don't want to... I thought it was going to show it. Stop you prematurely, but you don't want to go in the water. Cole is an electrical conduit, so if he touches the water, it's going to hurt him up pretty bad. And that's the whole lore of Infamous, is conduits are people with powers. We'll get more context on a lot of this stuff later in the game, where I will more than likely stay silent for us to get all that juicy story goodness, and also I want to enjoy it too. I think I've mentioned that before. That's what I really enjoy about these Let's Plays, is it gives me a good excuse to play some older games. Which, before I did YouTube, I never really found myself replaying old games. Not nearly as often as I would have liked to, because it's like, you know, games come out all the time. And that's always a legitimate concern of me. Like, if someone were to ask me, like, what are some of your greatest fears? Dying would suck, certainly, but I am, like, dead serious when I say, like, a legitimate fear of mine is that I will leave this earth not being able to do all the things I want to do, and that includes playing all the video games I want to play. And, like, right now, I'm trying to play Final Fantasy X-2, and now I'm doing this Let's Play, and then Watch Dogs comes out today as I'm recording this, and... And as this is going up, I'm assuming, yeah, Tuesday. And then the Sly Collection comes out too, and it's like, well, of course I'm going to play all three of those again. I love the Sly Cooper games. Which, by the way, I just recorded a bunch of remembering videos for that.
The water pressure has dropped in the main running under the bridge. What's going on down there?
Reapers were busting up some pipes.
Interesting. Let's see what I can find out. You worry about getting back into the city.
I did a bunch of remembering videos, and one of them was on Sly Cooper 1, so I'm really pumped to play that again, but it's like, you know, so many games come out, dude, like so many games. Shit. Damn it. I should really maybe shoot those ahead of time. And I still have a bunch of games on my PS3 backlog that I want to still get to. Because, like, PS4's out, you know. I'm trying to keep up with the games that I want to play on that, and I'm already falling behind on that. And I am definitely behind on my PS3 backlog, for sure. Like, I never finished Mass Effect 3 or Ni No Kuni. I have Need for Speed, Rivals? Yeah, Need for Speed Rivals on PS4 that I haven't gotten to yet. There's, like, that Child of Light game that came out. I want to give that a go.
You find John and the Ray Sphere, and I get you out of there. No questions asked. But you double-cross me or do something stupid, and I will throw you into a hole so deep that you won't even know which way is up. Got it?
Yeah.
Okay, we're out of here. Woo!
Cole? Oh, man, it's good to see you.
Hey, mission complete.
Yeah, nice work on that gate, wrecking ball.
Well, live through the fall, no problem. But, getting back to shore? Well, let's just say I'm no Michael Phelps.
Yeah, that's an understatement.
Hey, take it easy, Lightning Rod. So, how the hell did you live through that, man? Bullets flying everywhere, all over the place. Figured you were a goner.
Let's head home. I'll fill you in on the way.
I love these little blurbs in between.
And it drains neuroelectric energy.
Oh, I knew it! All the stuff I've been saying, every word is true. Government's in cahoots with a secret organization, the Race Sphere. Damn, it all makes sense now.
Calm down, you're gonna hurt yourself.
That Race Sphere must dish out powers to anyone controlling it. You gotta bring it back here.
Sure, I could use a sidekick.
Ah, hell with that. Zeke Jedediah Dunbar is his own man.
Your middle name is Jedediah?
Yes, it is. After my grandfather. Strong man for a man his size. I don't know where Zeke comes from, but I'm certain...
You need to take a nap and a bath. I got things to do.
I'm going to stop it right there, people, because we are, of course, out of time. So I'll see you all in the next Let's Play. If this is the one you'd want to agree on, by the way. I can change that up, no problem. See you in the next one.